guests, and Aussie TV legend Denise Drysdale is one of the funniest women to ever embrace our screens. And now she's teaming up with best friend Hazel Phillips for a big comeback. Craig, you got to catch up with them.
You know what? Sometimes you can get real lucky in life, and these two women are absolute dynamite. Take a look, it will speak for itself.
I can't even read a note. I don't even know what key I sing in.
You can get up in front of an audience and have them eating out of your hand. I wow
Australia's showbiz golden girls, Hazel Phillips and Denise Drysdale, are back and they're rehearsing for their new stage show. Between the two of them, they've won 3 gold Logies and have notched up over 115 years of showbiz experience.
115 years.
Oh, wow. You must have started early.
Any reference to my age and I may leave the set.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, it's OK.
Hazel Phillips was our second female gold Logie winner after Lorraine Desmond, but Australia's first female TV talk show host.
And they did a survey to see who the audience would like to see on their new Channel 10, and I came up top, so they put me on this show, which was...
What was
really
nice.
Sorry, I'm not interviewing you.
You go for your life.
I just want to say, how long did you do that for?
4 years. They published in TV Week, I think it was, that the two highest paid men were Graham Kennedy and Don Lamb. They said he was getting $6,000, Don Lamb was getting $5,000 a week, and I was the highest paid woman. I was getting $350.
Next question.
I'm waiting for you to ask it.
Sorry.
That's all right.
So, listen, do you like living on the coast?
Hazel was also the first reporter to go to Hollywood and conduct interviews. Now, back to you, Denise.
How many interviews did you do when you went to America?
Oh, about 92 in 2 weeks. I mean...
She just went from one to the other.
I even interviewed Sharon Tate just before she was murdered. Isn't that terrible? Omar Sharif.
Well, oh, you didn't? Oh, he's gorgeous.
Oh, he was such a chauvinist.
Was he?
Oh, yes. He said, I don't mind how long a woman takes to get ready for me. I thought, well, I won't be getting ready for you, mate. Fess Parker. He was gorgeous. He was 6'5" and he piloted his own plane from his ranch. And Helen Mirren, gosh, she was horrible. She'd been doing all these nude scenes and she didn't want anybody to know. So she was really up herself. She was really snooty. And I thought, what's the matter with you? You know.
Because you'd already done a nude scene.
Indeed she had. On our Sex and Sin soapy number 96, there was Hazel swimming nude, jaws dropped, and it made her an overnight sensation.
Well, as a matter of fact, it really frightened the hell out of me, and that's when I bought a
revolver?
No.
Oh, sorry.
A property in Bangalore and moved. Nowadays, I'd say, bring it on!
Denise began her career when she was just 10 on The Tarak Show, Australia's first live children's show.
I was in that for 4 years, where we used to do, and we'd mime songs and we'd do, and at that time was the first time that I was asked to do sketches. So that was fabulous. And then I left school and auditioned and got into the senior ballet. And that was short-lived because I only was there for a year and a half and I grew boobs.
So you were fired because you had boobs?
Yeah, virtually.
Denise was also under pressure from her mother, who kept her on strict diets.
Mum was very glamorous and had the outfits and everything. And so she thought you should be thin. And of course I was a dancer, so dancers have to be thin.
Oh, sure.
So I used to get... She'd put me on that fairy bread, Vita Wheat, so I used to get 6 of those for lunch. But in summer, I used to have a bike from Malvern Star, and I'd ride that to school in South Melbourne from Port Melbourne and back for a salad. And then I used to pinch money from a bag and buy a pie on the way back. Over the years, I think it's played havoc. I couldn't care less now.
No.
I mean, when I say that, I do care. But I don't care as much as I did.
Nor me. Rescue me. Come on,
baby, and rescue me. But Denise's voluptuous body is what made her Australia's first go-go dancer.
In 2005, I had my bosoms reduced because I used to be 38 double D, then I became 38 long. And so I could have tripped over them. And I had them done because I used to get rashes, and anybody that's in the same boat would know it through summer. It was so unbearable.
The guy I was with on the farm who left with a hippie, I thought...
With boobs?
Well, I'll do the opposite. I'll have some put on.
And what year was that?
That was 1974.
Let's talk about Botox. First, Denise, have you ever tried it?
It just hurts. I've got low tolerance of pain.
But I don't like the effect of Botox. I think it gives a waxy look to people. And don't you hate... Don't you hate the big lips?
You know, those... Hello, Hazel, how are you?
I'm very angry. I'm very happy. I'm sad.
It's always a barrel of laughs with these two. We also got a taste of Denise's famous chicken dance, her fly impression, and the sizzling bacon.
What about retirement? I mean, that seems such a dirty word, really, doesn't it? Retirement?
I will never retire.
Not as long as they keep ringing and asking. Through the show.
We've been here for about 5 hours. It's got dark.
How bad?
Oh, they're wonderful. And of course, they're going out on the road together. These two absolute treasures are teaming up, coming to a club near you. You'd be mad not to book them.
It's true. Yeah. Exactly. Make sure you do the sizzling bacon while you're there.
Oh, you can smell it, actually. She's doing it as well. Hazel could be her egg. Sunny side up. True.
Craig, have a fabulous weekend.
You
see
too.
See you next week. Fabulous.